What happens when two aloe vera varieties face off in a battle of the roots in water? Welcome back to the channel. This is my fifth video on growing aloe vera in water. In my first four experiments, I exclusively used the Chinensis variety of aloe vera. This time, I'm putting it to the test against the Barbadensis variety. We are going to compare them side by side to see which one performs better. We'll be watching to see which variety grows faster, roots sooner, and ultimately survives longer in this hydroponic setup. For this new experiment, I'll be using a total of four aloe vera cuttings, two from each variety. Before I placed them, I made sure the nodes on all the cuttings were fully exposed. The nodes are those small, slightly raised bumps on the stem, and this is where the new roots will emerge. By ensuring they have direct access to the air, I'm giving the plants the best possible chance to start rooting quickly. Here are the Chinensis cuttings, and here are the Barbadensis cuttings. If you're new to aloe vera, it can be a real challenge to identify the different varieties, especially when the plants are young, and even when you place them right next to each other. These two Chinensis varieties were grown in a partially shaded area in my garden. In contrast, the two Barbadensis varieties were grown in full sun. This difference in their growing environment actually makes the Barbadensis plants look a bit more compact and reddish. If both plants had been grown in the same partially shaded spot, it would have been even more difficult for most people to tell them apart, which just goes to show how similar they can be in their early stages. Now, I also want to show you a few improvements I've made to my growing containers. Based on my past experiences, I've learned a lot about what works and what doesn't. This time, I've placed a custom-made blocker at the neck of each plastic bottle. In my last attempt, I didn't use a blocker, and as the stems grew bigger and thicker, they got completely wedged in the bottle's neck. Removing them was almost impossible, and trying to wash the bottle to clean out algae became a huge headache. This new blocker will prevent that from happening again, making the plants much easier to manage. Another small but important addition is a rubber around the top of the stem. This serves a couple of purposes. First, it helps the plant stand straight and stable in the bottle, preventing it from leaning to one side. Second, it creates a small space where I can place pebbles on top if I want to. The pebbles won't fall into the water, and they have the added benefit of creating a barrier that prevents mosquitoes from getting into the water and laying their eggs, which is a common problem with any standing water. Just like in my previous videos, I'm starting this experiment by letting the cuttings hover above the water. I'm not soaking them. I've found that plants seem to root much faster this way. It's my technique to prevent the stem from rotting before the roots have a chance to form. For now, I'm only using plain tap water. The plants don't have any roots yet, so they can't absorb any nutrients anyway. They'll survive just fine on water alone for the first couple of weeks. Now that the plants are all set up and in their containers, can you tell the difference? With an untrained eye, it's very difficult to identify which plants are Barbadensis and which are Chinensis. After just 1 week, something interesting happened. One of the Barbadensis plants started to grow roots ahead of all the others. This was a surprisingly early lead. However, it's still far too early to jump to any conclusions about the Barbadensis variety rooting faster in water. By the end of the second week, both Chinensis varieties had also developed long, healthy-looking roots. But the first Barbadensis plant to start rooting still has the longest roots in the entire group. Here's an unexpected twist though. One of the Barbadensis cuttings still hasn't grown any roots at all. I've taken it out and checked the plant and its stem, and it looks perfectly fine. No signs of rot or any issues. It might just be a slower starter and is simply taking its time. This makes me wonder if root growth depends less on the specific variety of aloe vera and more on the individual plant itself. Let's take a closer look at the roots. Here are the roots of the other Barbadensis plant. You can see they are quite a bit longer and more robust compared to the others. Here are the roots of the bigger Chinensis plant. It's also started growing a tiny new pup, or baby plant. I haven't had much luck with pups in the past. They usually get stuck in the bottleneck of the container and eventually die. I'm really hoping this new container design will allow this little one to thrive. And finally, here are the roots of the smaller Chinensis. Now that all three of the rooted plants have a good root system established, I need to change the water and add some nutrients. I've prepared a special solution using liquid hydroponic fertilizer. I learned this from my first experiment. In that case, I used only pure water. The plants surprisingly survived for over a year, but they didn't grow at all, and their leaves were thin. They didn't die, but after a year with no significant improvement, I simply transferred them back to soil. This experience taught me that water alone isn't enough for thick, healthy leaves. The plants absolutely need proper nutrients to grow. In my third attempt, I did add a nutrient solution. The plant grew bigger with thicker leaves, but I eventually gave up because I got tired of changing the water every 2 weeks to prevent algae. Plus, the stem got stuck in the bottleneck, making it impossible to wash everything out. So, here's my new strategy for this experiment. Now that the water has nutrients, algae will grow much faster, especially when the water is exposed to sunlight. But I don't want to keep the plants out of the sun, because they'll get light-colored leaves and white bases, a clear sign that they aren't getting enough light. My goal is to find a balance. To combat the algae without sacrificing sunlight, I've covered the containers with black plastic. This will block direct light from hitting the water, hopefully slowing down the growth of algae significantly. I plan to keep these plants in water for much longer than any of my previous attempts, and I'll be sure to keep you updated on their progress. I hope you learned something new from this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment below to let me know what you think. This is Danny, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. God bless you.